Hey guys, it's Captain Ballarms. I go 114-3 on raid with the S12. My attachments are long barrel and fast mag. My secondary is attack 45. My lethal is a C4, and my perks are flak jacket, hardline, scavenger, and dexterity. My score streaks are orbital VSAT, canine unit, and swarm. And something I wanted to talk about is some tips on raid. Now, if you're playing raid, I generally like to rush the B flag and try and get a couple of kills while I'm standing on it to get a faster orbital VSAT or load star, whatever you're using, and it'll just help out if you manage to get a couple kills on it. Normally you can get at least one, and normally the enemies will rush it, so sometimes you can rush up to the flag and kill them and try and stand on it before you do it, so you get like 400 or 200 points depending on how many enemies there are, because they're not really going to be paying attention to you being there already if you rush from the start, because most people don't do that. And the only people that do that normally are decent players that actually know what they're doing. Most of the time, people get 50 points by capturing the flag, and then they run. Whereas if you just run from the spawn, you'll get there first, and people will be unaware. But another thing for tips is if you're using a shotgun on raid, I would recommend staying to the buildings, the really close quarters areas. I really wouldn't stay right where I am. I just tend to stay over here because I don't know why, it's just like how I like to play raid. I like to be in this general area, but I never really rush the building, and I think I need to start changing my playstyle so I rush that building more, because people camp in there all the time, and you see how I pick off two snipers right here. It's just, I think I need to start going into this building more, and maybe I'll be able to pick up faster kill streaks or score streaks so I can get a 200 plus. And maybe that's my problem on raid. I don't go in this building enough. I really don't know. But just stick to the close quarters areas, and it would definitely be best to stay around here or on the other side where, what is it, C flag? Just stay in that building. Those are definitely going to be the best places to be on the map. And with the S12, it's an underused shotgun in my opinion. I know this isn't a really impressive 100 plus in my opinion. It's just using the S12, so I decided to upload it since it is with the S12. You don't see a lot of 100 pluses with the S12. And I just said S12 like 50 times, so I'm sorry about that. And look at how I don't die here. This was crazy. I really expected to die. And I would run fast mags on it instead of extended mags, because with fast mags you're going to reload faster, and extended mags is only 4 more shells or bullets or whatever you want to call them in the clip or magazine. And that's why I really don't recommend. I'd just rather be able to reload faster, because you're going to need to reload quite often with this gun, and it can get you double kills pretty easily. It's a really good shotgun in my opinion. It's one of my favorites. And I'm going to be playing with some subscribers on this weekend. So if you want to, I'm probably going to play PlayStation either Saturday or Sunday, and Xbox one of the other days, like, depending on what. I'll probably play PlayStation on Saturday, then Xbox on Sunday. So if you want to play and try and help me go for the 200 plus, you don't have to run support, you orbital VSAT, UAV, counter UAV. You can if you want, but the main thing I wanted to run a full party is because I don't want to triple cap. If you agree to not triple cap or run swarm dogs, lodestar, then you can play with me, because I'm going to be going for the 200 plus, and I don't want it to be ruined because you guys counted out my streaks, and I know you guys won't do that. But if you want to play, just add me on PlayStation or Xbox. And I'm going to be doing some posts for posts over the weekend, so if you have a channel and it's about 100 subscribers or more and you feel generous and want to help me out, then just send me a message on YouTube and I'll respond to you. And I have a couple people lined up, so over the weekend you'll see some of their games, and then I might upload 2 videos a day just so it's theirs and then my video as well. And I'm also going to start working on my new series, which is random classes. So I go to a random class generator and I get the class, then I use it, get the attachments unlocked that it says that I need to use and the perks and everything, and then I'm gonna go for a live 100 plus. And I think that's a good series. I don't think anyone's doing it, and I really think it's a unique and fresh series that no one's really doing. I'm gonna search it on YouTube and see if anyone's doing it, but I doubt. I mean, they might be doing the random class 100 pluses, but I doubt they're doing it with a live commentary on top of it. Now, another thing that I wanted to talk about is the orbital VSAT can be such a help when you're running a shotgun or any gun. You just get that feeling that you can rush in and kill everybody because they don't know where you are. You have the opportunity to flank them and take them all out and kill them when they spawn and just be behind them and they can't do anything about it. And that's why I like orbital VSAT so much, but as you can see, it makes teammates triple cap, and my team is triple capping right now. And whenever you run an orbital VSAT, the chances of triple capping is much higher than if you were running a Lodestar or anything else, in my opinion. Mainly because your teammates know where the enemy is and they decide that if they're not by the flag, they want to take it. Now, I made a video on this, and I got my monitor a couple days ago, and it is amazing. It helps me out so much. I mean, the day I got it, I got like 350 pluses in a row, and it is just fantastic. I'm not dying to as much bullcrap, and I'm able to get that first bullet into my enemies, and it helps out so much. It's unreal. And I know that on that video, one of my subscribers posted and explained what MS time is. And the best way for me to explain it is it determines who gets the first bullet in. Because if you have a low MS, you're going to have the time to respawn to it if you have a good, reflex to get that first bullet on them if they have a response time that is more than yours. And that's basically the end of the game. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later.